Dans ce nouvel épisode de Lumière Sûre, on va déterminer si agriculture durable et technologie peuvent faire bon ménage. On est donc venu à Berlin, le temple de la tech européen, pour rencontrer Infarm, le leader de l'agriculture urbaine en Europe. Et c'est Isabella Sobieski, la directrice marketing, qui va nous guider.
Fondée en 2013, Infarm a développé un système de culture verticale en hydroponie. Leurs fermes modulaires sont placées dans des supermarchés, des restaurants et des centres commerciaux pour permettre aux clients d'obtenir des produits fraîchement cueillis.
Can you explain us the life of a green in your farm from the seed to the plate through the nutrients it needs to grow?
We use in our farm something that is, we call it a spiral. And the spiral is inspired by the sunflower seed. So everything grows actually from the in and to the out, which means when we start to harvest, we start from the inside and then it naturally goes and grows around so that the harvest always can rotate. And what happens is that, you know, that it's because it's always a constantly monitored and controlled, the light and the nutrition and everything that goes inside the farm actually helps in this kind of spiral to grow. So once you have the outer layer of the spiral, you can actually take it out and then it's ready because the plant is fully grown and then you can put it automatically like to your plate.
2 ans après la mise en place de son premier module, Infarm exploite désormais plus de 50 fermes à travers Berlin, dans les cuisines des restaurants, les rayons des supermarchés et les entrepôts de distribution. L'empreinte CO2 de la laitue qu'ils produisent est de 350 grammes contre 3,7 kg pour une laitue importée d'Espagne.
Nutritionally speaking, what is the difference between the greens you produce and those that grow in open fresh air?
So what I would say is that our greens are they're living plants because the root is still intact. When you have other like greens that, for example, grow in an open air, they're actually cut off their roots and then they're put into something and then they're transported and into something else because the supply chain is longer. What we do is that we actually, like, when you take it from our farm to yourself and then you go home with it, it's still alive because the root is intact, which means that the nutrition that the farm actually produces is constantly in the plant when you eat it, when you take it from in-farm. In an open air, it can also be so that it's cut, the roots, and the longer the transportation route is from the farm where it was cut to the supermarket, it loses its value because the temperature is not controlled and everything actually like decreases along the way, which means that the nutrition, of course, of that plant decreases. Whereas with our, it's not, it's a two-step thing.
Le but de leur ferme modulaire est de court-circuiter la chaîne de production. Plus d'import, donc plus de transport, d'émissions de CO2 et d'intermédiaires. Et en plus, zéro pesticide et 90% d'économie d'eau.
With 1,200 plants per month for a single farm unit, how do you plan to increase food self-sufficiency in metropolises like Berlin?
I mean, we've already started right now, yeah, because we started with all the plants that we have, everything from salads to basils to thymes, I mean, all the variations that we have right now. We also started with the partners that we have in the supermarkets or the restaurants where we are in Berlin. We are constantly doing a lot of like research and development in our departments where we're trying to find ways to see how we can do mushrooms or tomatoes or chili. So everything is already like, we're already in a testing phase of how we can even increase our, you know, our varieties to go into more fruit or vegetables or other spices that are grown like this.
Au lieu de construire des fermes hors de la ville et de distribuer leurs produits, Infarm distribue directement les fermes là où vivent les consommateurs. En supprimant la distance entre fermes et clients, Infarm crée un système alimentaire transparent. Mais qu'en est-il de l'avenir des producteurs locaux?
Do you feel that Infarm is restoring supermarket's image in the eye of the customer at the expense of local producers?
We are local farmers. This is our job. Farm in a different way than a local farmer does outside of a city or whatever, but the solutions that we have come up with is a farm in the city to make these kinds of products and cut the supply chain available for people in the city. You know, we're exactly like the local farmers. We don't see them as we see ourselves as equal. Yeah, and this is exactly the way that we want to be there, because we also, like, our goal is to have like affordable prices and teach people about this way of eating. It's not about competing with local farmers. It's just that.
Pour contrôler ces fermes modulaires, Infarm utilise l'intelligence artificielle, le cloud et le big data. Le système se veut intelligent et peut prévoir les produits à récolter, où et à quel moment.
Can you explain to our viewers how you use big data and machine learning to grow food in your farms?
We collect around 50,000 data points for our plants, like the plants and the growth of our plants and the environment of the farms that they are in. This is all then sent through to a central software station where we actually monitor and we watch the, you know, like we can learn everything about the farms that we have because of the software that we use, which means that we can learn about how do we control the light, like the environment, you know, should we improve something? I mean, basically the farms are constantly being optimized and adjusted to whatever needs that we can learn that the plants need, which means that we can constantly move in the direction where we want to make the farms also more self-thinking, so like they can understand which environment they are in, how much space they need, how much air they need, what the temperature is, because all of these components, they're very significant to what is happening inside the farm. And the support of the machine and the data just makes us improve whatever we already established. It's a constant daily learning because of this. So it's a great combination in this case.
Infarm a levé 25 millions de dollars pour s'implanter dans d'autres pays. La start-up a Paris, Copenhague et Londres dans son viseur et prévoit de lancer 1000 modules d'ici fin 2019.
Your growing method seems to have a lot of environmental pros, but it also seems to cut the human out of the food production. Do you think technology is the help we need to build a more sustainable food system?
The in-farms or the farms themselves, they need people that can constantly like be around the plants because it's farming, and we have experts, we have all kinds of people on board that are constantly working on this. And we have our in-farmers, which are basically the growers, and they are the ones who are taking care of the farms in each and every location where they are. So we are, you know, are schooling young people about this, about our farms, and we're teaching them about the importance of, you know, food and also the sustainability and the impact that we're making in the cities. So for us, it's like all about creating these opportunities for the people to be a part of the journey that we're on.
L'hydroponie est une solution pour réduire son empreinte hydrique et carbone tout en produisant toute l'année. Mais aujourd'hui, elle est encore loin de faire l'unanimité du fait qu'elle implique une culture hors sol sous lumière artificielle.
C'est la fin de notre enquête, mais on a plein d'autres reportages à vous faire découvrir sur notre chaîne YouTube Out of the Box, l'alimentation de demain. Abonnez-vous pour ne rien manquer du futur de notre alimentation. À vous les studios et à bientôt pour un prochain Lumière Sûre.